Now that I have this completely painted and I've started to cut it out. So the way I'm going to cut it out is I'm going to turn it over to the back and I'm going to cut very carefully and very slowly. I'm going to take my time. Make sure you have two fingers in the big part of your scissors and your thumb in the one part. My thumb is facing upwards, so it's kind of going up to the sky. I'm going to open it up. I'm going to cut it nice and neat. I know that these are really hard angles to cut, and so sometimes I'm going to turn my entire paper like this to get the angle that I need for my scissors. I'm going to turn the paper. I'm going to cut really small. And at other times, it's going to be too hard to turn the paper. See, I'm turning the paper now, and it's working. And it's working here. I'm turning the paper, and I'm cutting really small, and I'm taking my time. Remember, this is not a race. I want you to take a very long time cutting this out. Okay, now I've got to a point that's really hard to cut. So I'm going to start from down here, and I'm going to start cutting back up to that point. I'm going to cut all the way up to where I left off, right there. Like that. And it drops off that piece that I have cut. I'm going to put that to the side. I'm going to start again right here. Cutting up here and then around, taking my time. Once I get to the top of this tail, I can already see that it's going to be too hard to turn my paper completely around and cut it. So I'm just going to stop right here where this tail is and I'm going to start back down here. And I'm going to cut back up to that point I was at. Don't make it too hard on yourself. Go nice and slow. Make sure not to cut his tail off. I want to leave plenty of space there so that the tail doesn't get cut off. And then I can turn it completely like this and I can start again. This is just like Eric Carle's Blue Horse, the artist that could paint a blue horse. And remember that he was inspired by the artist Franz Marc from Germany, where he lived. And the Franz Marc painted a blue horse and a yellow cow, and it was very neat. Those were interesting things to him. Now that we're finished here, we're going to get a piece of paper and we're going to get glue. We want to make sure our name is on the back of this piece of paper. So we'll write our name and then we'll flip it over. Then we're going to glue our animal. Yours might not be a horse, but whatever you created, we're going to glue it down. So I'm going to get the glue. I'm going to make sure it's open so you can twist it all the way down. If there's any dry stuff, you need to pick the dry stuff off. And then I'm going to twist it open. I'm going to put my glue completely down onto the piece of paper. I don't want a whole lot. I don't want to be dripping glue. And then I'm just going to very small. I'm going to put just a little bit of glue all the way around this horse. Remember, it's not a puddle of glue. Look how thin this line is. It is such a thin line of glue. It's not dripping off when I'm done. You can see there, I kind of got a puddle of glue there. You don't want a big, thick line. I want my glue to be actually touching the paper, and I'm barely even squeezing it. I'm just really just kind of holding it and letting the glue come out. It's coming out very slowly. I want to see you putting your glue bottle all the way to where it's touching the piece of paper like this. I want it to actually be touching the paper. And just a very thin line of glue is coming out. You can see how thin of a line that is. I'm gonna go around just like this. I don't need any glue in the middle. And I definitely don't wanna see anyone just pouring glue all around it. Your glue bottle is touching the paper, actually touching it. Then we're gonna center it up, make sure that it's right in the center and it looks nice and neat. And then I'm going to press it down. And we may even need to put a book on this to make it dry flat. Yep, I think I might have to put a book on mine to make it dry flat. Here's one that's already dried. Once we're here, we're going to add the details. So we're going to add the details of this. So I'm going to need to put in eyes and a mouth. The way I'm going to do this, I'm going to start with a yellow here, a colored pencil, and I'm going to draw an eye. Then we'll draw another eye. I'm going to color it in green. taking my time, making it look really nice. And then I'm gonna outline it with a black. Then I'm going to add the mouth. Just like that. I'm even going to add a few lines here in black to make it look like he has these curves. So I'm going from point to point, making it look like he has these curves. Just like that. You can see that I've taken my time and I've cut it out each one of the little legs, making sure not to cut any of them off. And now it looks like a finished piece. You can see how nice that looks.